What's up? My name is Adrian Per, and I'm a director, photographer, and I run a production company called Lumpia Watermelon. How I got started doing what I'm doing today is I always wanted to be a creative. I always found myself excelling and expressing myself. Even in my earlier days of school, I wasn't too focused on the academics, and I never really quite knew what that meant until probably late high school. I just found myself just like struggling in school. It wasn't my path. And I knew that after dropping out of high school, I didn't only have to double down on this. I had to like triple, quadruple, 10 times figure it out as a creative. My first music videos were actually on an iPhone. They were on the iPhone 3GS. Since I didn't know rappers, I made some rap songs and I shot my own music videos to it. Me and my homies made rap songs and that was my subject. I didn't approach creating knowing I was going to be a director, a photographer, run a production company, or be a producer. I just knew that I wanted to create. My parents didn't understand it at first, but I think they're pretty proud now. I've had the opportunity to work with artists that I'm actually huge, huge fans of, big fans of their brand as well. Everybody from like Lil Nas X, Meg Thee Stallion, Migos, Jhené Aiko, Black, Polo G, you know, Lil TJ. The list goes on, you know, brands like Nike, Spotify, Apple. I've got to work with people who were role models to me, who inspired me as a kid, like E-40. He's the king of the Bay. I never would have thought, but I always knew. And I think that kind of confidence and that kind of delusion is what helped me get here. I've run into so many speed bumps along the way. And I think part of what makes me such a hustler is that I really came up through a lot of adversity. I grew up in inner city San Francisco. You know, we moved renting apartment to apartment, and eventually, you know, one of the houses that me and my family was foreclosed. They gave us 17 days, man, to move out. And I was in college at the time. I actually ended up getting my GED. I was trying to get a degree at an art school, actually. And I was too embarrassed to tell anybody. And I lived 4 months just out my car. You know, fortunately, I had friends who were able to lend some couches to me, lend their showers to me. And I was shooting music videos for some of the hottest artists in the Bay. And I still had to Uber to make ends meet. I still was delivering food, you know what I mean? I worked at a candy store for minimum wage, you know what I mean? Like, I think it's the Filipino hustler in me. It's in our blood to overcome. It's a resilience that we all have. The craziest part about that is that in the middle of that 4 month span, my car got broken into. My camera was in there, my clothes were in there, my shoes. I was literally living out my trunk most of the time in like a bag. And the only thing that was making me money got taken away from me. I might have looked lit at that moment, but I was so lost trying to figure myself out. Looking at it now is such a big part of how I got here, because ultimately I saved up enough money to give some money to my family. Say, yo, we could buy a house. One of the biggest lessons I learned along the way is don't let your ego get in the way. When I first started getting real money, man, I started flaunting it. And a lot of that was ego driven. I wanted people to see that I made it. And ultimately, it didn't make me a better person. I think this is something that I've learned recently, actually. Your ego is what's holding you back a lot of times. Even at this point in my career, I still take pay cuts. Sometimes I won't make money from shoots because I'm so passionate about it. And I think the more ego driven self back in 2019 would have been like, hell nah. Like, look at me. Like, I'm doing work with XYZ. Like, why I gotta work with you? You know, you notice the most basketball teams, the ones that work best are the ones without the ego. It's a fact that if you wanna go fast, go alone. If you wanna go far, you gotta go together. I'm working on this project called We Are Golden. And it's actually a play on words. You know, just growing up in the early 90s, you know, people would call us yellow. They would call us crazy names, man. And, you know, I love gold. You know, I wear gold jewelry everywhere. And I would just jokingly say, nah, we golden. We gold. So I have this passion project called We Are Golden that's dropping in May for AAPI Month, which is Asian American Pacific Islander Heritage Month. And I have an in-person live gallery where I actually took photos of every Asian culture, from their food, parents, grandparents, their religious practices, adversities, similarities, differences, just their faces, man. And that's actually gonna be in LA on May 14th. So, you know, if you're free, come out to it. It's a free event. It's gonna be really dope. I just wanna unify all of this, man. Like, while we're all different, we're also all similar. Advice that I would wanna give people who's trying to pursue their passion in life is believe in yourself. As simple as that sounds, as cliche as that sounds, the statement is true. You're crazy until you're right. And you just need to have a genuine meaning behind what you do and be passionate about it. If you're doing work that has passion behind it, that has a real statement and mission behind it, people will see that.